was standing by the tracks waiting on a friend. I see the headlight in the distance, he's a-coming in. The horn is a-blowing and the steel is a-rolling. Stop, look and listen to him. Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I see? Oh, there's nothing like the sight and the sound of a train. You gotta stop, look and listen to him. Traveling trains all across the land. Oh, I testify that I'm a railroad fan. Rocking and rolling on the long steel rails. Nothing like hearing that old whistle wail. So won't you take a trip with me? We'll go back in time to the old rail lines. Take a good look through the camera's eye, 'cause you never know what you might find. Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I see? Oh, there's nothing like the sight and the sound of a train. You gotta stop, look and listen to him. There's a rumble and thunder of old locomotives, clicking and clacking on the railroad track. You better stand back, Jack, 'cause this train's flying. Stop, look and listen, or you could be dying. Oh, now life is like a train, my friend. Oh, it passes by, then it comes to an end. So you take it all in and don't you miss a thing. Keep your camera in your hand and you'll be a happy man. Standing by the tracks waiting on a friend. I see the headlight in the distance, he's a-coming in. The horn is a-blowing and the steel wheels a-rolling. Stop, look and listen to him. Do you hear what I hear?
A picture-perfect autumn day with great lighting on this branch line to Troy Grove, Illinois. Interstate 39 is directly behind me. C&W arrived at the sand plant usually in the mid to late morning and departed toward DeKalb in early afternoon, hauling hundreds of cars of silica sand throughout the week. On this nice summer day, about 2 in the afternoon, 4328 is about ready to depart, but first, the crew will take care of a little bit of paperwork business. On a different day, a very windy day, I catch the sand train heading eastward, just about ready to go under I-39 just off to the right. I'll meet this train up at Earlville, Illinois, where the Burlington Northern and the CNW have their diamond. I took many photos of the CNW in this area. Here's a few photos of the trains at Troy Grove and Earlville. Many of my photos I have made available on photo CDs. And for our final CNW train, we have an eastbound coming through the diamonds at Rochelle, Illinois. I-652 was painted up into the bicentennial colors, and this is what it looked like a few years later in July of 1979.
How's it going, Dave?
Good.
On May 5th, 1994, 652 finally arrived in Baldwin, and on May 14th, it was dedicated with special ceremonies and plenty of train rides. Further eastward, I set up for another shot. This loaded coal train originates off the UP from Black Butte, Wyoming, and is destined for power plants in either Plains, Illinois, Wheatfield, Indiana, or Michigan City, Indiana. The CC operated about 20 to 25 unit coal trains a month. As a teenager in the 1970s, it was scenes like these that I remember with the Illinois Central. I couldn't believe my eyes that in 1993, I could still see the same locomotives running after all these years, but under the Chicago Central Green Diamond. Many of these locomotives were built in the 1950s. 8258 was originally built in 1953. 9413, a Jeep 18, was built in 1960 and still has its original Illinois Central Green Diamond. The Chicago Central acquired about 17 ex-Milwaukee Road Jeep 20s, which originally were Jeep 9s. AD63, a Jeep 10, was built in 1954. The engines are backing into the service area to take on fuel, water, and sand. There is also a turntable here at Wallace Yard, Freeport.
car.
I can't tell you how meaningful it was to capture this Chicago Central action. To me, it was the Illinois Central all over again. In 1994, I followed the whole Chicago Central line from Council Bluffs, Iowa, to the Joliet, Illinois area, trying to capture as many Chicago Central trains as I could, along with rolling stock and cabooses and some depots. And all of those pictures are available on my Chicago Central CD. Mendota, Illinois Railroad Museum has two of the Illinois Central Highliners you can come to see. The old track to get onto the Burlington Route Denrock branch can be seen here in the foreground. And the switch to the left goes to the Black Brothers factory. Here is a view of what the grounds looked like before the Mendota Museum and Historical Society started the Railroad Museum in 1997. locomotive is seen here on the ex-Illinois Central main line of Mid-America. When the Illinois Central abandoned the line in 1986, the Burlington Northern took over the job of serving Motor Wheel. Just near these railroad ties here is where the old Illinois Central interlocking tower stood. The Burlington, the IC, and the Milwaukee Road all crossed here. The tower was torn down in December 1980. Once again, the BN Mendota Local is coming from the Motor Wheel plant. The track crossing over the pavement is where the Milwaukee Road joined with the IC. Please pause the DVD if you wish to view the static pictures you will see here. They are also from the Diamonds here in Joliet back in July of 1979, photographed by my friend Harv Kahn. Here's a view of just some of the tracks here at Clearing Yard. Thank you. Coming around the curve and into Chicago Union Station, we'll be arriving shortly on Amtrak's Illinois Zephyr in August 1992. At this time, the Metra trains were still being led by some BNE-9 locomotives. Here are some Burlington Northern trains between Mendota, Illinois and Earlville. Well, now I would like to take you on another trip back in time and share with you some family videos and photos, and you'll see my interest in trains has always been there. I never thought my interest in trains would lead to this, the construction of the Mendota HO scale model layout of the tracks of the three railroads and the Main Street downtown area. I spent about 2.5 to 3 years building it from about 1994 to 1997. I spent countless hours of research and collecting photos and information, but what really helped me the most was that as a young man I had grew up here and I knew the layout of the tracks. And after all, in the 1970s, most of it was still there. When the Mendota Railroad Museum opened in August of 1997, The layout would be one of the attractions. The Grand Union Depot with the three railroads that came to Mendota would be depicted. The Illinois Central, the Burlington Route, and the Milwaukee Road. Building the layout was a huge undertaking, and to maintain it takes a lot of work too. I want to thank all the volunteers who helped over the years, and especially Jim Carroll, for leading the way.